Hello there, what's up? Today I will show you how to make a real wireless mobile charger. You have already seen many wireless charger on YouTube, which is does not work properly. Now the question is, homemade wireless charger can work like a factory made charger? Is it possible to install a wireless receiver in an ordinary phone? Like I put my phone on the charger pad and it start charging without connecting any USB cable in my phone. Yes, it is possible. So let's get into it. While making the charger, I opened an induction heater and study it to know that in which way I can get maximum watt and make it a powerful. Here you can see a beautiful copper coil and which is oscillated with 220 DC volt. I will use the same process to make the wireless charger. The only difference will be that was 220 DC volt and my is 5 volt DC. First I took a black fiber glass which will work as a charger pad, and I cut it out as much I needed. Now it's look like a rectangular board, and I removed the plastic guard from it. Now it looks glossy, and I made 6 holes in it to make it stand by some screw, and tied every single screw with washer by a screwdriver. And now I took 3 pieces of 24WAG copper wire and twist them together like in the induction heater coil. We need 10 feet of this copper wire. Now I made a hole in the middle of the fiberglass and take this copper wire through the hole. Now you round up the copper wire like this and fixed it with glue. It will take while. Now I took a n-channel MOSFET and attached with a heat sink, and after that attached it on the glass pad with some screw, and I connect MOSFET's drain pin to the copper wire first pin. Now we need to 60 to 70 Hz oscillator which will run by 5 volt. So I put a 555 timer chip on the breadboard, and of this IC's first and second pin I connect a 104 PF, and I connect a jumper wire IC 2nd pin and 6th pin, and I connect another jumper wire on IC's 4th pin and 8th pin which is positive pin. I connect a 1K resistor IC 7 and 8th pin, another with 6th and 7th pin. I connect a 1K resistor and diode from IC's 3rd pin. And also I connect a Schottky diode between MOSFET drain pin and positive. I connect this diode because to stop getting feedback to the MOSFET. Remember guys, in this kind of diagram, it necessary to connect a Schottky diode to the positive and drain pin. Because if you don't connect the Schottky diode, then your MOSFET will be burned quickly. Now I take out the gate, source and drain pin and connect with the MOSFET some female jumper wire. And it worked perfectly. Temporary circuit worked perfectly, but now so I made a permanent circuit for it, so it looked pretty good. Now I put the oscillator board on the charging pad and soldered all the gate, source and drain pin carefully, and second pin of the copper wire with the oscillator board's positive pin. So our wireless transmitter pad is almost ready. So now we need a 5 volt power source. I choose a 5 volt mobile charger which give maximum 1 amp. I put here another USB socket which will help you to charge a power bank. Now we need a wireless receiver which will help to catch magnetic frequency. So now I took a 34WG copper wire and round up it 120 times. And I connect a LED strip with two of its end. I switch on the wireless transmitter. Check out, it's work very well. and you can see this 4 watt LED is glowing very bright. Remember that its output voltage is 80 volt. So I made a full bridge rectifier with 4 Zener diode. I saw the volt terms. This is estimated to be 8 volt. But there is a one problem here. We need 5 volt to charge the phone. So I used here ME117 SMD regulator IC. You can find this IC old PC motherboards audio section. There is no need to add a condenser. Mobile power supply is already there. And locked the back cover of mobile. If you have any question about this project, then go to my blog and write the comment. Blog link available in the description. So friend, this is for today. This video is very useful, so please share this video. If you like this video, then like, share and subscribe. Please support me. See you again on another video.